for the final electrocutor for the one derivative. Once again, everyone, welcome back to the Video Game Dungeon. I am Commander All Rocks, and I have here with me today...
Epigeo!
And this is part 3 of the Resident Evil HD remake on the Xbox One. Today starting, Epigeo will be playing, since Commander All Rocks I played the last time.
Yep. Oh wow, this is my first time playing with the non-tank controls too.
Yep.
I don't know how I feel about that, I might change it back. Alright.
Either way.
Yeah, last time, sorry about that folks, the video cut out early at the top of the stairs here, I believe, and yep. We just picked up a key from the crypt.
Which key? We can find out by expecting it. We could look at the,
I kind of want to use one of these, but...
We should probably...
Because I'm going to need an inventory slot.
What we need to do is mix it and then use it when we're in bad danger to bring us back.
Yeah.
And handguns full.
I know you said they're...
Slot, and then when we get down to red danger, then we can use it and bring us back up to hopefully at least yellow or yeah. Green.
Okay, so we're going to progress through here now.
Here comes the epic hallway. Secret item. Behind the case.
I kind of want to switch it back to the tank. There it is. That key did work for that door. That's good.
We knew it. We knew it was coming.
Can you switch it back to me?
Yeah.
Please?
Sorry, everyone.
Sorry, what was that? That's fine. Perfect.
There you are.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
We all... No, we're not.
Still saving. I like the little blood splatter for the save icon.
Yeah, that is it.
Very Resident Evil.
We are back with tank controls, guys. I had to get it back to the old school way. Ooh.
Ooh. Don't be scared now, ladies and gentlemen.
You know, I know these games, you can move cabinets a lot, so...
There's always hidden items. In the mansion. Ooh, it's a protective dagger, a defensive dagger. I like that when they added that into this game, where you can use the little daggers and stab off the zombies or the grenades.
Yeah, the dogs too, and some,
you can stab the dogs.
Yeah.
I don't think you
can. They help you with the crimson heads, definitely. Cause...
That's why I try to light my zombies on fire to make sure they don't come back.
Oh, yeah.
There's always that one moment when you're running back through the hallway and you're fucked on items or healing, and then you got one of those motherfuckers in there waiting for you.
Right.
Ooh, nice. Perfect.
All right.
Always so no use ammo on Resident Evil.
Oh, yeah. No threats in this hallway yet. That's good.
Nope. Let's see what's maybe behind the door. Maybe they never will be.
Wow, that is a kind of a scary shot because you don't know what is on the other side of your face.
You know, the camera turns with always the top-down view, very similar to Silent Hill. They always have some sort of a top-down view somewhere in the game. I think it adds a nice effect with that angle because you don't know what's coming around the corners when the monsters or zombies attack, like in here.
This room has got some of the best... angles, though, I'd say, as far as creating the suspense with just that.
Scenario.
Ooh, creepy-ass bathroom.
Oh, is the nasty water in the bathtub?
It's full of dirty water. Move the plug. Not yet. I don't know what's under there, so...
Come on.
Remove the plug! Remove the plug!
Remove... Okay. Now that I know nothing else...
What's happening? What's in the bathtub? I know.
Hopefully a key. Oh boy. Not good, dude. Not good. So this is my first time taking on a zombie in this, on
off.
An Xbox One controller.
Take him off. Take him off.
Should I?
He's leaking nasty
if I can.
Water out of his mouth.
Yeah, you know I have to take
him
off. Bop.
Oh, didn't even need to do it.
That's good. I didn't have to waste any ammo.
Relief.
I like it.
Look, he's throwing up. He's gonna handle the death and nasty. And there's no vomit in the toilet.
That was a quick cut. End cut.
Another defense dagger.
Take it, man. We are racking up the stuff.
You know,
we need to find our storage, though, because running out of room. I don't want to carry on ink ribbons if I'm not using them.
Yeah, it's a wasted inventory slot. You definitely don't want to do that in Resident Evil. You need every slot you can get.
Right. Now I'm going to go around this corner real slow.
Keep them slots open.
Okay.
It's always good to have an extra few open. You always find some ammo or a healing item or something good you're going to need.
Really dark in this room.
Oh yeah, that's why the lightning will guide you. That's how you see.
Yeah.
So it adds to the atmosphere, the suspense, the eeriness of the background. And
there's hardly any games that have done that as good as this.
Uh-oh. Don't become a chill sandwich.
Some cool art in the wall.
It's just amazing thinking back on the original release of Resident Evil. And looking at the HD remake.
Yeah, they added detail to everything.
Yeah, a lot of detail. Take that shotgun, it's going to be a prime. Oh, yeah. Always grab the ink ribbons when you got them in your inventory. Just stack them. It's also another thing you're going to need.
So. I don't have a lighter, do I?
Nope.
Nope. I think Chris starts with a lighter.
Chris has the lighter, yeah. All
right. Oh, a dagger.
Another one.
Three in a row. That usually means there's some threats coming, so. All right, so the shoddy on the wall.
That takes up two slots, I think, though. No. Nope, thank God.
Great.
Was the flamethrower? They used to take up a couple slots.
That's way later. Oh, yeah. Oh, what's going on? The controller's vibrating.
It'll be a Jill sandwich.
Oh, wow, great. This is great. Is anybody going to help me? Can I get out of here? She's just so nonchalant right now. Oh my god. Damn it. Kick it.
Oh no, kick you're gonna die.
I know shooting it won't help. Okay. I'm just gonna run around. Hope something triggers.
Maybe.
This door?
Hopefully.
Oh my god.
Oh god. What did I do now?
Oh god. She said the same thing.
Wesker! Barry!
Wesker.
Help!
Barry. I don't think Wesker's coming.
You're a cop. Kick down
Barry,
the door.
The door's jammed!
Stand back!
Move!
She's right by that door, too. She would have got. She would have got a bullet. Oh, yeah. And that's a magnum bullet.
That would have went right through the door and into her.
It would have creamed it.
You almost became a Jill sandwich.
Almost became blood stew.
Don't do it. You almost became a stain on the tile.
Thank goodness Barry came back. We're into where he was in the in between time.
That was a close one.
He's in the novel.
A second
late.
You could fit nicely into a sandwich.
We recommend those novels. Those are really good.
Thanks. The S.D. Perry.
Yep.
But Barry, didn't you say you were going back to the dining room to find other clues?
Nice little side story.
I'm glad not, but why are you here?
I just had something I wanted to check. Anyway, we should get back to searching for Wesker and Chris.
Well, he's being sketchy.
He's always sketchy.
Thanks, Barry.
Because we all know why.
I owe you one.
Good old Wesker.
Don't mention it.
But what about Wesker? That's a question.
What a great guy.
What a great guy.
Oh my god.
Eisenberry. That's funny.
Just like Brad Vickers. Wow, he's the best guy. What a great guy.
Great job, Brad. Thanks. We love you too, fucker. It's all your fault. God damn it, Brad.
You idiot.
Remember Forest Spire?
Yeah, I think he's somewhere. Somewhere in this
laid
mansion,
up
too.
On the patio, like
he might be alive. I don't know.
I'm fucked. You know what's a funny?
Oh my goodness!
Stamina.
Oh, I forgot there was a quick turn.
Uh-oh! But the good news is the stash is around that corner.
I was trying to press A to shoot him. I didn't know as you hold the left trigger and then pull the right trigger too.
Yeah, watch out! There's one upstairs. Get that healing herb.
I'm full right now, I think. Oh, yeah, I probably could have combined it from the screen, but.
But no, you already have full inventory, I think, because the shotgun filled up.
Sometimes you can combine it still, even if you're full.
Ooh,
at least in some of the games.
The flask. You see a handgun clip.
Get in the flash!
Get in the flash!
I don't think I'll need this right now. I'll pull out as much ammo as I can. Put the ink ribbons away.
Should we save it first?
Yeah, you know what? I don't think it'll hurt. I'll do
that. Let's do all the shuffling first and then save it. Like, pick up
yeah,
the flask.
Yeah.
And No. Go and grab that healing herb.
I'll just edit this shit off. No.
We do not want to save right now.
It's this controller. I'm not used to it.
Bingo. Ooh, and the document.
Whoa, okay.
Special instructions for disposal of dead bodies. We have new information regarding those beings. They may appear to be dead, but in fact they're able to come back to life. However, there are ways to prevent them from becoming active again. Currently, there are two known methods to cease their resurrection: incineration,
destruction of the head,
and destruction of the head.
Smash it or shoot it.
Before the methods are discovered, you will be notified immediately.
Whoa.
Meanwhile, to those of you who still have to will to live, oil has been placed on the floor of the mansion. Take as much as you need.
Take that oil, burn them bodies.
You'll need something to light it with, which you'll need to find by yourself.
Oh, thanks, game.
Thank you for the oil and the flask, but, you know, we don't need a lighter. We'll find one in the zombie apocalypse.
I don't need to,
get the hangman glue.
Oh, yeah. I don't need to burn that last zombie because, you know what, I blew his head off. Blah! Should I carry the shotgun
right now? Destroy the brain, destroy the ghoul, you know what I'm saying?
Do you think I should carry around the shotgun right now?
Honestly, we don't need it for a while. Not until we run into the hunters.
I can handle the zombies without that.
That emblem I'd take.
You sure?
Nah.
The knife, I won't, this isn't that kind of playthrough, so.
Yeah, we don't need the knife. Basically, we have two open slots, left three once we save it and return the ribbon back to the stash.
One last thing. Always
do this. Always keep it full, yep. Did you save it? Yep.
Always reload and always save in the game.
That's what I'm saying. In every video game, save often. You don't want to get screwed. One false move, one enemy, ruin the whole damn thing.
Yep. And this isn't lenient like most games where it'll just put you right back everywhere.
It's the last time you save is where you start back up again at, so.
And like in Fallout and some other Bethesda games, there's a lot of auto-saving.
Yep, checkpoints or auto-save.
Alright, I think really we're good. We're gonna go see what else this mansion has in store. Well, upstairs now. We're going to the second floor on the east wing.
Second wing of terror, second floor of terror.
I'll keep this one apart for now. Alright. I heard a Zambino up here earlier, so.
They're lurking. Uh-oh.
Looking for a herd?
Hobgoblin across the floor.
Where you at?
To the right, to the left, everywhere.
Oh, no. It must be to the other way.
Yeah, it's to the right, behind you. Come around that corner.
He's not, it would auto. It's not auto-locking on him, so.
Yeah, he's hiding around the corner, waiting to surprise you, trying to bust out on the camera. So.
Hey, how you doing?
I don't sense the character yet. Oh, fuck! He got the drop on me! I'm a bad zombie.
Does he have a beard?
Oh, yeah. Bearded zombie, bro.
Is this a hard? Jesus. Or like...
Got a lot of those defense daggers.
Six or seven in them, didn't I?
Yep. Boom.
Oh, that got him, okay.
Yep, he wasn't coming back. Burn that ass.
Light it up!
I don't have the lighter yet.
Oh, fuck! That's right.
Let's see, maybe it's one of these rooms, you know?
You can't get in there and they're not fucked up. Okay. One back there leads to, like, a reading room. Like a study room.
You unlocked it.